Alright, so this is a new episode for these two levels. Whole Hog. This may take some concentration. Heck yeah! Now there's just one other level to do. Now, the difference with this level and Lights Out is the Aku Aku masks go out a lot faster than in the other level. So this will also take some concentration, because I'm going to need to focus on when I need to jump and be careful. You
down. dumb.
Okay, so now Full Hog and Fumbling in the Dark are both complete. I have all of the gems. So now let's go ahead and take a little look-see at the Great Hall. Let's see what lies in wait. That's something. Oh, by the way, I found out this Bandicoot's name is Tawna. T-A-W-N-A. Tawna. Something's going on here. I wonder what. Papu sold the ruins of Castle Cortex to a resort developer. He then used the proceeds to open a big and tall shop on the island. After intense therapy and 8 years of higher education, Dr. Ru went on to write the well-received book, Through the Eye of the Vortex, a study of rapid evolution and its consequences. Koala Kong moved to Hollywood and landed a motion picture deal of universal proportions. Currently, he's working with a speech therapist to improve his diction. Pinstripe moved to Chicago, where he now owns and operates a citywide sanitation company. He's saving money for his upcoming Juvenational campaign. After the disappearance of his mentor, Dr. Nitrous Brio rediscovered his first love, tending. Bar. The world has heard nothing more of Cortex since Crash foiled his plans, but evil geniuses are harder to squash than cockroaches. What the hell just happened? I'm very confused. That felt very silly, though. But that is everything, folks. All 26 gems, both keys, and the relics are really just for 106% completion or something, so I'm not gonna go for those. Especially not since, you know, levels like... especially since levels like, what's it called? The high road are absolute asses to complete. So, I believe this is the end of Crash Bandicoot 1. So, next time, folks, we will begin Crash Bandicoot 2, Cortex Strikes Back. I really enjoyed this first game. While it definitely had its moments of making me rage, I still say it was pretty enjoyable. And I'm glad I could get everything done. Well... wait. No. We're not done just yet. I almost completely forgot about one more thing. Oh boy. Until next time, everyone, I will attempt to complete Stormy Ascent. I have... doesn't show how many lives, but I do have a lot of lives. Oh boy.